did these sessions on English language. So we choose this primary language for our sessions. So if you are having any problem or any certain aspect of anything applied to you, to use Urdu. So we would translate it to
Well, like I would like to I would like to ask other participants, are they familiar with Urdu and Hindi? Because I see multiple Indians and Bangladeshis have joined us. We were not expecting responses from outside the country. So if you are comfortable with the for the primary language like Hindi or Urdu, so it would be best in that case. Otherwise, we can switch to English for sure. So write down your responses in the chat section so we can analyze really quick. And for that, we will try to upload the lectures on YouTube with a subtitle so that people from across the across the globe and mostly from outside the country, outside Pakistan, can understand. Yeah, we can do bilingual, Zainul Abidin. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. So you can ask us about anything and stop us in the lecture. Okay, be sure to raise the hand first, right? So if you are going very fast or you didn't get any particular topic, so you can ask us about that. So first of all, let me give you a brief introduction about myself. So I'm a full stack developer, but I have a primary expertise in front-end technologies because you got to be a master of one, right? So my main focus towards the front-end technology, and I started my career at Zenvius. In here, our co-founders, Zenvius co-founder is also here. So now I'm currently working as a freelancer on multiple projects. On the other hand, Noor, you can introduce yourself also.
Yeah, please. Can you please forward the slide?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me introduce myself. You all are familiar with me from the WhatsApp group that I've been messaging quite a while. My name is Noor Muhammad, and I'm a senior software engineering and computer science student from DHA Suffa University, Karachi, Pakistan. I am currently enrolled in eighth semester, making my FYP and doing job in a Singaporean startup, Get Butlers. Also doing freelancing. I've started my career with Zenvius. The co-founder is with us. And you can follow me on various social media channels, GitHub, LinkedIn, and Medium, and Facebook, and there are so many. Just write down, connect with Noor on and Google, and you will be bombarded with my social links. So I would be glad if you people can follow me. Also, move forward, Faran.
Okay, so about ACM DSU.
Yeah, about so, ACM. Yeah.
So what is ACM? So about the ACM, it's an international and society for computing. It was founded in 1947. Like. So it's a basic introduction of our site. It has claiming to be nearly 100,000 students and professional member as of 2020. About ACM DSU, so ACM DSU is linked to our DSU chapter as we are studying at DHA Suffa University. So ACM DSU. So ACM DSU, which provided us the platform to teach about React, is a student chapter working under the body of ACM. In past, they had multiple successful events like Pedalex, Spectrum. Here's a list of it. Also, Stretch, Our Code, and Freshman Cup. And also, big events are coming soon. So be sure to check them out. About the course. So, okay. That's aside about the ACM, about the course. So, okay, about this course. The goal of this course is to make a community. So, first of all, we must for hanging out each other. With each other, so we have sensed that there's no community about React, like there's no functioning community. So in the community, like people can help each other out, and also we can learn about React and other aspect of React and know about the newer libraries coming to React and recent changes in the React. So we will create a community where all developers can help each other out and also provide us lesser learning curve for us all, right? So with providing with the expert providing us with the expertise, so we would have a lesser learning curve in the React. And also after this course, we will make a group for all of the developers so that you can discuss problem, also post about some exciting new things in the React. Okay.
All right. Yeah. So I have shared my screen. Is my screen visible? Can you switch to my screen, please? Is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yeah, great. So I would like to introduce ACM and about the course once again. So what is ACM? As Faran already mentioned, ACM is an US-based international society that works with the association of, that actually abbreviated with the Association of Computer Machinery. Currently, they have more than 100,000 students enrolled as of 2020. So I have just gone through the website of ACM that in case you guys are wondering what it is, so you can switch to their website. And if you want to join, they have a very easy to understand form. And if you want to join, you can join them as a student or as a professional. So if you join them as a student, you will get various perks, just like you will get access to their research paper, their library, their teams, their plannings, and so on and so forth. They are just globally very much famous. Also, what is ACM DSU? So ACM DSU is the DSU, DHA Suffa University chapter that works under the governing body of ACM, the Association of Computer Machinery. It is founded and initiated in our university since December 2014. And since then, they have organized various events, including Betalex, Spectrum, and various others that you can see on your screen, including this one, which is our so far the biggest and so far the a new approach toward the remote learning. We haven't done it remote learning earlier. So about the course, that is a very much interesting part. So why this course? Like what about in this course? So first of all, I would like to say that the team DSU, ACM at DSU has done tremendous work, tremendous efforts in designing this course and in designing the curriculum of this course. They have been working on this course for past a month now since I have joined with them. And what we are expecting from you, I think I have added a slide here. What we are expecting, we will come forward to it. So what is prerequisite of React? So what we want from you people to join us and to work with us in this bootcamp, but what are the prerequisite of it? So you must be familiar with JavaScript. We don't want you to be an expert in the JavaScript. You can be a beginner, but you should be willing to learn. You should be a student, a participant with a passion, with a fire inside you that you can learn on your own, and you can be a member, a responsible and a helpful member to a community. We are building a community. We are designing a community, not just to instruct you and not just to teach you, but also we will expect every one of you to help each other, to respond to each other. That is why we have created Facebook group. If you have the Facebook group, you can join us in the Facebook. You can join them. Definitely you should join. And if you don't have, so I will share the link at the end of the video, in the end of the lecture, or I have the link in the WhatsApp. Yeah. Also, we will go forward towards the super fast paced JavaScript. What should I say? JavaScript overview in the next class, in the lecture two. Today is just an introduction. What we are expecting from you. So we are expecting from you so that you should be willing to learn on your own. We will instruct you, we will guide you, but you should be the one who will Google things. Remember, Google is your best friend. Google helps you in every of your difficulty. Also do YouTube, go to Udemy, Udacity. There are multiple sources that you should explore if you are willing to learn. All right. Also, what are the rules and regulations of this bootcamp? Obviously, we will not tolerate anyone abusing, anyone disrespecting, disregarding any of the color, race, gender. We would like to be, we would like every of the participant to be respectful to one another, be helpful to one another, and to do everything that a good gesture, a positive gesture shows. Also, this bootcamp, you will not get certificate that easily. You will be assigned few tasks. Even I have prepared a task for you in this introductory lecture. I will explain it when we'll move forward. So you will have to complete all the assignments on the all the tasks, and at the end of the parties and the, at the end of the bootcamp, you will be issued a certificate that will be good and that you can attach with your resume. Also, each participant shall be marked for every positive gestures to other member. Just like I explained earlier, each participant will be noticed and will be marked for all the good things that they are doing. That will help us to highlight the students, because we might ask for your CVs at the end of the bootcamp for the jobs, and we will distribute the CV on multiple software houses that you can work with. You can work with us, you can work with them. It's totally your choice, but it will be benefit if you show your good gesture and positive gestures to our other members. Also, ACM DSU reserve the right to disqualify any participant at any time. Just like it sounds, it is what it is. ACM DSU also reserve the right to change the time and days of the class, and we will definitely inform you about that. So what's next? Course outline. Faran, can you join us and explain the course outline?
Yeah, sure. Okay. Okay, can you see my screen? So, course outline is similar to what we have posted earlier. So, first lesson is a lesson about the course, about us, about what we will do in the course, and how would all the course will go around. So, as Noor has mentioned before, so we would be strictly taking your taking your all that your work you have done and all the assignment we have very strictly marked that at the end of the course you will have certain favors to you, and you will be assigning some certificate and also have an opportunity to work with us or also work with certain jobs also, because we will be forwarding your CVs to other firms. So then second class, first lesson would be this. Second lesson would be a basic JavaScript lesson. So we would give you a basic lesson about JavaScript, in which we clear out all the JavaScript concept and what will be used in the React. Then there will be a session on React, Git, and native installation. So those of you don't know about Git, Git is a version control used for controlling all the versioning and also committing your code and also and managing all your code. So after that, there will be Netlify. Netlify is a very popular library for framework for deployment. Then we will be discussing about React basics and the most highlighted issue, what would we use class components or functional component. Then React router. And after that, Redux for state management. And after that, we would have some discussion. What would we do beyond React? So these are the basic lessons of the React, and these are compulsory lessons. After all of these lessons, you would have a basic understanding of the React and can be able to deploy, make, and version all version a basic app, and much more depending on your learning ability. So first of all, I would ask you a question. What and why React? Can anyone answer?
The because it is the most useful library nowadays.
Why is that?
How do you think it is useless? How do you think it is useful?
As I had seen, I'm a new student in computer science field, and I have seen that there are a lot of jobs in React, and it's getting trending framework nowadays in JavaScript. Before that, we have other frameworks, but nowadays everyone is learning framework of React. So there would be a reason. I don't know the reason exactly, but there would be a reason that everyone is going towards React, React Native, React. So that's why I tell that it is useful, and that's why I'm learning it.
You have given a very useful point, and we will be discussing that why it is very popular. So first, I think we would start with what happens when we go on to the website. So just as we log into the website, what does is we give it an address, okay? So as we give our browser an address, what the server does, the server gives us three files, HTML, CSS, and JSON, JS file. So these about these HTML is about structure, text, while CSS gives us a certain styling, and JavaScript inserts certain interactivity to the site. So how website work is all of these files are given to the browser by the server, and the browser renders the website, then user clicks the website and requests another page for it. So this is the process of basic website. So what happens after that? All of these, when bigger apps are made, so JS file become bigger and bigger. So there are certain libraries for it, handling all this JS file. But mainly after that, jQuery comes. Okay, so what jQuery comes, jQuery gives us a unified structure to work with it, which gives a basic unified structure, gives us a code. So it will be run on all the browsers and would be not dependent on other cross-browser performance would not affect. So after that, there were some issues with the Ajax. So what comes after that was Angular. So Angular was at that time worked on a model view controller architecture. So what model view controller architecture does is there are certain JS file divided into the models and certain view and under the controller element. So this was good at the time, but as was Facebook, for the Facebook, the problem arises that Angular procedure at the time where data was hard to manage, and also changes might affect on the component with certain changes in some other component. So if like, if I'm clicking on this component or I'm changing this component, so certain effects might create a problem for other. So it would be hard to manage from all the developers. Like if you are working in a certain structure, like some developers are given some bit of code and some developers given some other bit of code to interact with. So these problem arises. Then came React. React only deal with the viewpoint, a view of the model view controller. So if this approach gives us a certain certain ease to use certain ease to use an interactive UI without touching the DOM. So it gives us a basic layer between the DOM, which is virtual DOM. So we don't have to interact with the DOM. We have to create the view of it. So I think this is mainly the point of view of it. So what does it say when the Facebook launches the React? At the time, Angular was a hit, but when the Facebook launches the React, it was really easy to use and had a really lesser learning curve to it. So much of the audience moved to React instead of Angular. So Angular at that time was Angular changed all the model of it. So but in that time, React gained a lot of popularity on it. And since that, there's a lot of jobs in React, and there's a lot of popularity gain in React. I think there are certain libraries also coming like Vue, Gatsby, Next.js, which are gaining certain popularity. But I think React holds the majority votes. So after that, so why was React developed? So basic, I have given you what the basic complexity of Facebook architecture and shift from the MVC mentality. So these were the basic issues from which React was developed. Okay, so this is, I think I'm Marcel Salisag and give you the history of React. So important of React, React is then acquired by many big platforms like Netflix, Airbnb, Facebook, Instagram, Discord, and much more. It is open source, so many of the changes, people can also do changes on it, and working with only the Vue part of the content that I have given you. So it has a lesser learning curve, and you can create a really big, site and also small sites using React. So React is a library, first of all, but it contains a lot of packages, a lot of tools to let you create a bigger and better environment. It gives you server-side functionality, it gives you lazy loading, it gives you closed splitting, which is, I think you would know about this terminology yet, but again, after this course, you will be familiar with all these technologies and why React is the number one popular library to use. So the popularity of React and its job rate. Noor, you can.
Yeah, shall I share my own screen? Because I think it would be more feasible for me to explain things on my window. All right. So guys, please, we will work out on this one so that you don't have to switch screens. But just for now, can you all please switch to my share screen? All right. Can you see my screen? Where were we? Popularity of React. Yeah, great. Kumail, it's a library, not a framework. React is a library. All right. So the popularity of React. So the popularity of React, I have divided this thing into two things. Like one of the thing is the popularity, and the second one is the job rate. So apart from slides, I want to show you some real demographics and some real collections from various websites that I have figured out while surfing. So as we can see on GitHub, on the official repository of React made by Facebook, we have 165K stars. That means it's quite popular among the developers. They are very much working on this ecosystem and also liking this particular library. Also, if we go over the Stack Overflow, let me just this one, the Stack Overflow. I have this comparison of React, Angular, and Vue.js. So if we compare it from 2012, you can see the chart of the Angular.js was gone up, but it is drastically dump. Like it goes down in 2021. Also, if you see the Vue is quite newer. It's quite newer in comparison to Angular and React, but it's even not as much popular as the React. So if you see the React chart, you can see it's parabolic. It's just going forward and it's just going up in the skies. That's why we have given, that's why I said that fasten your seatbelt. We are about to launch a spaceship because it's like a rocket. Also, I would like to show that the community and development, if I show you something like where it goes. Yeah, so the growth of a JavaScript developer, it's based on 2015. So the growth of a JavaScript developer increases 25% every year based on the data of Make It by CNBC Global. And the average pay is around $83,000 US dollars. This is a lump sum. This is a median, actually. This is a median. Also, let me find one thing. I don't know where. Yeah, here it is. This is the Stack Overflow 2020 developer survey report. And let's just skim through the report and see what the developer says about various aspects that we will cover within our bootcamp. So first of all, if we talk about the programming, scripting, and markup languages, JavaScript is marked favorite out of 57,000 developers. They have 67.7% developer marked JavaScript as their favorite and most usable languages. Also, if we go down and see the most loved and wanted language, so it's marked as 58.3%, which is quite good. And in the wanted, it's 18.5%. It's the second highest language. Also, if we go more down, so highest salary worldwide, if we just check this out, so an average JavaScript developer is paid $53,000 as per the Stack Overflow 2020 developer survey. Also, if I visit, if I just search around React, so a web framework, we have React in number two. JavaScript is not actually the framework. React is developed to eliminate jQuery. So JavaScript has been marked favorite 53.9 times, more than Angular and more than Vue, which are their main competitors. Also, so these are some demographics of the popularity of React and its job rate. So you can see it's heavily populated, it's heavily popular, and it's very much high in job rates. As you can see, the average JavaScript developer average JavaScript developer hour rates are 60 in United States. So if you work in a remote company that is US based, you are more likely to pay it higher. Yeah. If we move forward and look out the comparison with Angular, it's something interesting. First of all, I mentioned this topic to explain you why React was developed and what are its differences in comparison with AngularJS and Vue.js. But then I thought that instead of explaining it myself, I would like to give this two assignment to all of you so that you will understand how React is different in comparison with AngularJS and in comparison with Vue.js. So what you have to do, it's an assignment, and the deadline is next class. The next class is on Tuesday, same timing, 9 to 10 p.m. Pakistan Standard Time, GMT plus 5. So what you have to do in this assignment, you have to write a document, a Word document that should not exceed 300 words, and you have to explain why React is what is the difference between React, Angular, and Vue.js. Remember, it's not pros and cons, it's not advantages and disadvantages. You just have to figure out the differences by your own. So that is your first assignment, and I wish you all the best on your assignment, Scott. You will be marked on your assignment, and at the end of the bootcamp, you will be given certificates because based on your grades. So next, pros and cons of React. Faran, continue, please. Yeah, I will make a Google form, and Vue.js, Shiraz, let me write it, Vue.js. Tommy and Ashad, I will make a Google form, and you will be asked to upload your assignments on that form. What would you suggest those developer who find JavaScript complex? All right, so it's an interesting question. Thank you, Ross Cyber, for asking. So JavaScript is not as much complex, it's easier. It's an scripting language. It doesn't have a data type restriction. And you can do multiple things that you can't do with other high-level languages, just like Java and just like C#. So you just have to practice on your own. Although we have a JavaScript overview from basic to like advanced, not that much advanced, but if you have experience with JavaScript, you can cope up with us. It would be really hard pace. If you find any difficulty, any complexity, we have a Facebook group, you can ask questions, and I am expecting our dear fellows, dear students, dear participants would help other participants to make things easier for them. Also, me and Faran, they will be monitoring and they will be answering questions if we found anything interesting. All right, Faran, can you proceed, please, with the pros and cons of React? This Faran, you have your mic is muted in case you're speaking.
Okay, sorry, I was having some network issues. Okay, so I think if you have any question before that, or we have continued the session. Or if somebody doesn't have. Okay, no need. Okay, so about that, there's a discussion about learning React. So some say it's a linear way to learn React, like you have to learn HTML, CSS, JavaScript, then React. But I think you can learn both ways. Like I started right at React. Like I didn't learn about the basics of Java. Somebody's mic is off. Noor, can you? Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So I started like. I think Noor and me started React at the same time. So I started have the basic understanding of JavaScript. Like I watched a series on YouTube. I would So one more point. I would share all the links that we have gone through with our experience and all the YouTube and all those mentors, and we'll be sharing link of that. You should watch them. Before the first lecture, it will be helpful for you. And before that lecture, you would have some of the understanding. You would ask us about the questions of it. So, okay. So that's a really important question. So I think
we will be sharing resources.
And YouTuber. Yeah. So yeah, we will share resources in the Facebook group, and I think there's a Tesh, YouTuber named Tesh. He has a really concise and good series about JavaScript. You should watch that, but you can wait for our next session. It will be about the JavaScript. Then we will be hopping to React.
Yeah, so for all those students that are not that much familiar with JavaScript, so let me tell them that I will be conducting the JavaScript. We both will be conducting the JavaScript overview in the next class that will be on Tuesday, same timing, 9 to 10 p.m. Pakistan Standard Time. I will come to it, Ehtisham, just a moment. So, yeah. What was I saying?
Okay, wait, I'll share the link of it.
It's on Wednesday, Roha Sabir. Yeah, so I was saying that I will be sharing a useful resources of JavaScript so that users can visit and learn JavaScript themselves and they can practice on them. And if after that they have issues, they can surely ask. But what we expect is from you all is to make effort on your own. If you can do it yourself, you can conquer any mountain, you can conquer any difficulty if you have the willpower, if you are willing. We are your mentors. We will help you, but we will not spoon feed you. That's the most important thing that we would like to highlight in this introductory sections, introductory part, that we will not spoon feed you. We will help you. We will show you directions. But to knock the door, to open the door, it's your thing. It's your responsibility to do it. I will post.
Yeah, you sure, we will post.
Yeah, sure.
We will post assignment in WhatsApp group and also in Facebook group. So, and be sure to submit that on time, because as of the rules, we would accept the submission after the time.
And yeah, further on, any questions on the course? Yeah, if you have any questions, you can proceed. Thank you, Ikra, for highlighting the assignment. If you have any other questions, you can proceed. We have 15 minutes more. We have more 15 minutes to go on. Assignment, Ikra just mentioned assignment above your message. Muiz, can you look? Also, I will be posting, we will be posting assignment details along with a Google form so that you can submit in WhatsApp as well as in the Facebook
chat. I wanted to ask a question do you guys can recommend any JavaScript courses or like React courses on Udemy or Coursera? Like if they are paid or something, but they are good, because there are so many courses available over there and we don't know which one to go for.
Yeah, Maz, really good question. For JavaScript, we can refer you some of the useful resources. For the React, I see that React is an open source library, so it gets updated quite often. If you see, React is currently version 17. It's updated in October 2020 last year. And so it's really hard to find up-to-date JavaScript tutorial. Obviously, you can follow any tutorial from YouTube or from Udemy, but that is not a guarantee that it is outdated or it is the way industry and it is the way developers are working. So I would suggest you to follow along with this bootcamp, because we will be teaching you most up-to-date JavaScript functionality, up-to-date features, and also we will be giving you the way developers work. We will not be, we are not kitabi kide. So we have experience of how things work in real actual industry. So we will be giving you advices. We will be working on how actual developers work. So just follow along with us. And obviously we will be sharing resources as it goes on. Class timings.
And also some advice I think would be to, instead of follow along some tutorials, I think you should go and check out, there's a great documentation of it, which is MDA JavaScript. There's Mozilla documentation for JavaScript. I use it a lot in my daily tasks. So it gives you all the basic functionality of JavaScript. Like if I write some of the basic function of array, you can see my search also. So all the functions of search are given here with all the examples. So just write MDN, JavaScript, and what you want to search. If you want something about HTML, it gives that also. So there's a Mozilla documentation for HTML also. So be sure to check this out and know what are the all the tags, HTML tags, and what are the basic functionality, because these are also necessary for it. JavaScript uses basic JSX, but this comes in handy. There's also MDN CSS for all the CSS out there. And also I would recommend W3 School. So these are the basic documentation. So I think instead of following along all the boring tutorials, because I can't do that. Like I have a big problem of following along all the tutorials. I stop at half of the tutorial. Like every tutorial I have stopped at the half of. So what I find easy is to read these documents. I think most of you would find this helpful also. Okay, Bawal has a question. Is it better to be full stack dev or front end insufficient for job market? Really good question, Bawal. I think there's a certain element of it to the full stack development, as most of the, if you're doing freelancing, so full stack developer is a must. So there are the many jobs they are really requiring full stack developer. But if you're doing a certain job, like if you're doing a job in a company, so I think you should be more towards a certain tech, like you want to be a front end or you want to be a back end. Some companies are like full stack, but I think to be expert on it, you have to be expert on something, right? You can't be expert on all of the things. So and also the job market, freelancing is a different field. Job market is a different field. Job represents something like you have to research, develop, and all these changes to it. You have to become an expert on this. You have to optimize the site. You want to test the site. You want to write test cases. You want to write a basic or a very optimized code so that you are not only providing certain services to somebody and giving an MVP. First, we should learn HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Question. We're giving a certain MVP to someone. We would be giving a certain product to someone. So it should be a perfect thing. First we should learn HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Kind of no. So for React, you just need to have a certain understanding of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So that would work. You can learn that parallel, and some of it you will get along the way. So that's not necessary for it. So what I would recommend is go through some of the documentation. Like if you go to W3 school, you can go through all the HTMLs out there. So you might have a basic understanding of it. Instead of learning all the HTML, CSS, JavaScript, then to React. So React mostly uses JSX, which is a similar thing to HTML, but gives us a different element to learn from. Which IDE would be using? So I mainly use VS Code for my work. And also you should, I think it would help you to download extension bundle, React extension bundle. So it gives you some of the snippets and all these necessary things to work on. Like if I show you my VS Code. So if my VS Code is visible to you, so there are certain extensions I think you should install for it, like which helped me a lot. So there is a
Faran, your screen is really small. So fonts are really small. Can you please zoom it out? Zoom in.
Okay, sure. I think I can zoom in all.
Yeah, we will take a snapshot of it. And
okay, so I will give you some of the basic snapshot. I'll also provide you the link to download these bundle for your extension. So extension are really helpful. Like there's a Java extension pack, Python extension pack. There's also React extension pack for it. So you can also search for it. Like if I search for extension pack. So these are the basic extension. You can give you all the links to it.
Yeah,
sir, you can install it before the class.
Okay, who was saying anything? Please continue.
Yes, I was saying that if you close the message box and zoom it out, then it would be the screen would get bigger and the rest of the screen would get smaller.
Sure.
If you close the message box and zoom it out, not in.
We are, I think, I think there's any more questions.
Noor is also sharing.
We would surely give you the link. Sure, don't worry about it.
All right. So two questions that I'm finding very repetitive. First one is if someone doesn't know HTML, CSS or JavaScript. So me and Faran, we will be sharing links right tonight. So you have like around a few days to proceed that. And also second question that we are getting very much is that if someone hasn't filled the registration form and just joined the Facebook and WhatsApp group, firstly, we had it mandatory for all to fill out the form, but now since we have marked our bootcamp, so if you are in a Facebook and in a WhatsApp group and you are showcasing yourself, you are helping other, you are showing good gesture, you are doing all the tasks, all the assignments, you are participating, you are speaking, you are chatting with other group members, you are basically showcasing yourself, so that you that will make you eligible for the certificate. You are a part of the team. If you are joining this session, you are joining all the session, you are considered as a part of the bootcamp. No need to fill out the form because it's already just closed. We will be covering ES6, ES7. Yes, we will be covering advanced JavaScript, ES6, ES7, up to ES9. Me and Faran, we will both covering these things in the next session. Also, I would like to show you something. Faran, can you show the roadmap if you have, or shall I share my own screen? No, not that one. That picture that have been posted on Facebook. If you have that one, it's well and good. We haven't planned to apply a discrete maths yet. There is a link of WhatsApp group in the Facebook group. You can join that and vice versa, the link of Facebook group in the WhatsApp group. I will share it again if you are in the Facebook group. Just scroll down a bit and you will find it out.
Sir, I can ask?
Sure.
Sir, I have a question. In a week, how many classes you will conduct it? And secondly, the question is that after doing this bootcamp React.js, so what will we do next for future? Like so there are some people's like I also want to get money or earn money, but there is not enough like kitchen level. I want to grow up my level. So what should I do more?
Okay, I got your psychology from that kitchen word that you just said.
Yeah, it's a good word.
Yeah. So for that, if you are familiar with front end, just React, even an entry based, we will help few students. We will help the passed out. We will help the certified student to get the job. We will collect their CV. But for that, you will have to work on your own. You will have to showcase yourself. You will have to make projects, do tasks, do extraordinary things that we have not asked you to make eligible for that. Also, there are many jobs. There are many React.js jobs, as I shown you earlier. I had collected few resources, but I think that one is lost. If I find it out, I will share it in the Facebook and in the WhatsApp group. So yeah, for the money, everyone, we are all developers. We are here to make money, right? We are here to sell our skills, sell our time to make money. So definitely, if you are skilled enough, if you can make applications, if you can make your client's dream come true, you will be paid for that. What is the pace of this bootcamp? The pace of this bootcamp, so that's a good question. So I will try to explain things as much as I can, but for that you have You have any question you can ask for that. Regarding the pace of the bootcamp, I will be explaining various things really quick and like keep my pace slow on a few things that are more important. But you are welcome to ask me anything. But I will be giving you time to ask questions. Just don't interrupt me when I'm speaking. Me and Faran, we both have a different kind of teaching style. So I would prefer if you just ask me when I allow and when I ask students to ask questions. Yeah. Also, regarding the class schedule and the weekdays, we will be conducting our bootcamp for a month, 1 month from today's start date. We will be doing this twice a week, Wednesday and Saturday, 9 to 10 p.m. Pakistan Standard Time, GMT plus 5. Also, any other question?
Yes, sir. Like, I have another question related to React.js. Like, after completing this course, only we have skills of React.js. Could we do make an application for the client, or we do something else that that will be plus point? And we can do in a short period of time.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Okay. Just Faran, I have shared my screen to show you something. Although time is up, but let's just wrap this question out. So, can you see my screen?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So, can you see the roadmap that I've just opened? Speak out, someone. I can't see your screen.
Yeah, you can see
that. Okay, so today's session is just here. The next section, we will be covering JavaScript. We have various topics and we have to cover it really fast because we have a limited time frame of 1 hour. So just bear with us and you will be asked to question us at the end and in between. Also, we will be sharing resources before class two, so you can prepare yourself with that. Also, we will be covering class three, how web work, the installation of Node.js, what is NPM and NPX, Git installation, repository creation, Netlify deployment. This is because you can host your applications on cloud, on internet, so that you have a unique domain of just like a website has, and you can show your domain to your client, you can show your domain to your public, you can showcase your work to other fellows in this bootcamp. Also, I will be explaining DOM manipulation, as someone asked earlier, what is DOM? So we will be explaining what is DOM and what is meant by DOM manipulation, what is JSX fragments and all this stuff. We have a mini project that we will together be making. It will be a word counting application, a really small application that will cover all this thing that will explain, that will work out. Also, we will be working on Redux. It's a state management library that works with not only React, also with other front-end libraries. So after what beyond React, that's the question of that guy just questioned. So what beyond React? So we will be giving you a few resources and we will be giving you a few directions that you can go on and that you can pursue to be more experienced, to be more fluent towards React library, that most developer aren't. So that help you to make is that it will help you to fluent with the coding style, fluent with the React, and it will be enough for you to take your first job and earn your first penny, either via freelancing, either via doing an on-site job or an online job. Yeah, so that's our motive. And for that, we would like your concentration, your help, your support, and your togetherness. Yeah, and after that, you all will be asked to make a final project before the certification and before this bootcamp ends. Yeah. So that's all.
Well, my last question is that if I'm like, can you ask all members of the group, like, if you conduct this session in Urdu, it will be, I think, more helpful for me. For me now.
Yeah, so
if they mind, then you can.
For that, what I should say that I will be asked. I would say that I will ask about the feedback in the Facebook group, and whatever the majority will say.
Yeah, sure. We have created a feedback form for every class. At the end, you will be given. It will be posted on Facebook. So be sure to fill it out. And if you have any queries or any problem regarding the course, we would like to hear about that. And also, like we have discussed, there will be a community for it after the course. So we will be helping each other out for freelancing and for getting projects, or if you have any understandability of the project or having any problem towards anything, so we will be happy to help out. And also we would like to have other students to help out each other, so it would create a sense of community. Like I think we have seen on some other platform, like I think I've seen some of the Java developers group. There's a really good group, and also like you have seen a Sunny Ali group. So they are helping each other out like really much. So I want this to happen for React, so everyone could help each other out and help in earning money and also freelancing. Okay, yeah, we want that yes. too also, but. Sure, we'll take a poll and also create a form for it. So if the majority vote yeah. in Urdu, I think it would be good to go for us.
Yeah, Zainul Abidin, we will consider your feedback in mind, and we will surely create a poll on Facebook as well. We were told that we have registrations from various countries, including Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, US, and I guess Germany and Portugal. So we decided to
Tommy said
so we have many people, so we can't neglect any of a single person here, because yeah. everyone is as important as another one. There is no discrimination here, so we yeah. will ask about a poll here, and let's see what majority says, and whatever the majority says, we will make this thing work out. And in case if the majority selects Urdu or Hindi, Tommy, you can get benefit from it, because you can ask questions on the Facebook group, and also you can watch the recorded lectures, because we will, the team DSU, ACM DSU, will try to upload the lecture on YouTube subtitled in English. So you can watch that in English, and also you can be a part of a community. You can be a very useful resource to every one of us. Yeah. Anything else? Or should we finish it out? Should we end the first session?
Okay, I think there aren't any more questions, right? Can I say something?
Sure. Mic is yours at the time.
Actually, the thing is that nowadays, if you go to any country, or some of the people are talking about the freelancing, you do freelancing or whatever, or you go to an environment of job, you need to speak in English. You can't speak in Urdu. That's the major thing that I think that we should learn English.
Can you repeat question?
I was saying that nowadays everyone is speaking in English. So my friends that are saying that we should learn it in Urdu, it's a good thing. But the thing is that in today's environment, you had to speak in English. You had to make yourself able to speak in English, because if you go towards job sites or freelancing, you need to speak in English. You would deal with foreigners like Tommy here. So you need to speak in English. So it would be a better option to speak, to get lectures in English, so that we would be able to speak in English and make ourselves more fluent in English. That is the reason that
excellent.
I suppose that we should learn English.
If you don't know what my answer, Noor, can I answer this question?
Sure.
Yes. The thing is that Noor and Sir Faran want to enable Pakistani students. We are not focusing on English. The theme is that we want to make every person developer, programmer. So if the person do not know English very well, then he cannot understand, and at the end he will not get into a deep dive in React or any programming language. Or agar Urdu mein kahun to wo bazan ho jayega, fir wo chhod ke chala jayega.
Okay, sorry. Moist, okay. Tumhe kaat raha hu main. So Moist, koi baat nahi, koi masla nahi, koi iska masla nahi hai. And Ehtisham,
koi masla nahi hai. Moist, we will consider in our mind. Ehtisham ka point bhi acha tha, Moist ka point bhi
value. Ehtisham ka point bhi acha. Yeah, pehli baat hai, class khatam ho chuki hai. If you want to leave, you can leave. Simple discussion kar rahe hain, hum bhi five baithe hain.
You can leave, mujhe maza aa raha hai. Agar koi join karna chahta hai,
wo like jo mujhe puchna hai abhi puch lo later.
This is a community, no one will be judged on what they speak, as long as they are respectful and they have their words make sense and logic.
Yeah. So Moist, बड़ा अच्छा सवाल है, बड़ा अच्छा जवाब भी दिया आपने. तो जैसे कि मैं पहले बताया था, तो I think ये सीन ये हमें करना ही है कि मतलब हमें सबके लिए मतलब एक अंडरस्टैंडिंग रखनी है. तो और ये भी सही पॉइंट है कि मतलब आप फ्रीलांसिंग की साइड पे जाओगे या किसी भी बड़ी कंपनी में जाओगे, सो यू शुड एक्सप्लेन इट इन इंग्लिश. लाइक सबसे बात करना होता है, उस गोरे को समझाना होता है. लाइक
यार मोइस, मेरी बात सुनो, एक बात सुनो
और बताओ.
अगर तुम पाकिस्तान में, या अगर तुम पाकिस्तान में काम कर रहे हो किसी सॉफ्टवेयर हाउस में, वेल एंड गुड, बहुत अच्छी बात है. बट उसके साथ साथ हर डेवलपर फ्रीलांसिंग करता है, और वो फ्रीलांसिंग में किसी गोरे के साथ ही कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कर रहा होगा, किसी गोरे के साथ ही कम्युनिकेट कर रहा होगा, और उसके लिए आपको इंग्लिश आनी चाहिए. आइदर यू स्पीक, आइदर यू राइट, बट यू हैव टू कम्युनिकेट इन इंग्लिश, राइट? सो उसके लिए जरूरी ये होता है. यार मैं या फरान, हम लोग ओ लेवल के बच्चे नहीं है, हम मैट्रिकुलेशन के बच्चे हैं. थोड़ा थोड़ा हम लोग भी कर रहे हैं, सीख रहे हैं, सिखा रहे हैं. वी विल ऑल ग्रो टुगेदर.
यकीन कर रहे हैं, मैं अभी ना अंगूठा छाप बंदा, अंगूठा छाप मैं इंटीरियर में, इंटीरियर
सीनियर. नो इशू, नो इशू. अरे हम लोग भाई इंटर के भाई, हम लोग ने भी नहीं पढ़ी स्कूल, हम तो कॉलेज में.
हमने 9th से इंटर तक क्या दिया है, हमें पता ही नहीं. इवन के हमें पता ही नहीं, हमें पेपर किसी और ने दे दिए, पता ही नहीं. हम ऐसे बैठ कर आ गए और A1 ले लिया हमने. तो मैं अंगूठा छाप नॉट एन इशू. मैंने पहले स्टार्ट करी है जिंदगी में अपनी, ऐसे बैठा हुआ था, स्क्रॉल कर रहा था, बस आ गया बूट कैंप और ये चीजें वीजे, प्रोग्रामिंग में अच्छा लगा मुझे, तो मैं पिछले 30 महीने से मैंने स्टार्ट
किया. अच्छा,